Hey, how's it going? So I have another little project I want to work on today on the Royal Enfield, and that is I did pick up one of these motorcycle dash cams. So I got this dash cam right here, and it comes with two cameras. So there's this rear camera, 1080p camera, and then this 4K camera for the front. This here is the actual recording device, the box that you stick under the seat, and it has a Wi-Fi connection here for connecting to your phone, and then a little slot here to put your SD card, and then the wires. So this cable here runs from the box and gives you this controller from the front of the bike, and I believe this is also what contains the GPS. This wire here is what connects to directly to your battery. So these two wires here will connect directly to the battery, and then this third wire connects to your fuse box, whichever fuse turns off when you turn the bike off. So that way the camera turns on and turns off when you turn the bike off and on. These wires are the cables for the cameras, for running the cameras back to the box. So obviously the recording unit will go under the seat, and I'm going to run the front camera up, and my idea is to actually drill a hole right here in this headlight cover and mount the camera on the inside, and then just sticking out a little bit right in the front there, and then do something similar on the back on the cowl, is to drill a hole right here in the cowl so the camera will be mounted on the inside and then just poking out through the back right there. It is metal, and I've never drilled in metal before, and because this is at an angle, I'm not gonna be drilling flat because I want the camera pointing out this way. So I'm gonna have to somehow drill in at an angle like that. And I'm a little bit hesitant to do that since I've never drilled in any kind of metal before. So I did go ahead and I have this kind of junky plastic cowl here that I'm going to kind of do a test drill. You can see I've drilled holes in this thing before for a selfie stick. There's a hole there. There's another one under the vinyl right there. So I'm just going to do a practice drilling right there just to see how it goes, just to make sure I get it right and at the right angle before I even attempt doing it on metal. But the first step before I go drilling any holes in the bike is I am just going to get everything connected, everything set up. So connect it to the battery, get the wires run, the cameras connected, just to make sure it all works and that it's giving me the quality that I want on the bike before I go poking holes in the bike. So I am guessing that this device can fit somewhere here under the seat. And I'm thinking like right there. Let's see if... yeah, seems like that should fit there just fine. So the first thing we'll need to connect, these two wires need to go directly onto the battery, and then this will need to go onto something inside the fuse box. So one of these fuses here. All right, let's see if that will fit back in there without coming loose. Get my reading glasses so I could see what I was doing better. Don't get old, kids. All right. Now I can connect this box up, connect the cameras, and then just see if it works before I run all the wires. They do give you this little, tiny little screwdriver. So let's see if I can do this without losing the screws. And looks like it's showing this direction. Just to test this out, I am not going to put the screws in. So let's see that's the front 4K camera. All right, so it is so hot right now. Whew. Looks like it's over 110 degrees in this garage right now. So they do have the app, which I'm guessing I have to download, so I should probably do that first before I try anything. Turn on. I'm not sure. Oh, there's a chime noise, so I'm guessing it turned off.
Start video recording. Wi-Fi on.
Next. Connect the dash cam to Wi-Fi. My password is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 6, 7, 8. Connect.
Wi-Fi is connected.
So I'm guessing maybe add a device. Let's see, while using the app. Dash cam for motorcycle. User got Falcon 1. Is there a Falcon series? True. Connected. Oh, we have video. So this is this camera here, and I still have the protective Inception. I still have a little protective plastic over the front, so I'm not gonna take that off yet. So the quality isn't quite what it should be yet. So that's the front swap. And that's the rear. Right there, you can see, yeah, there is a difference in quality. Swap again. Swap. Oh, I just took a picture. All right. Pretty cool. All right, so that was actually pretty easy to get connected, get it set up. It only took a couple minutes. You just had to connect the two cables to the battery, one to the fuse, and it's up and running. So now the next step is just gonna be run the wires. So I have, this is the rear one, which should be pretty simple. I'm gonna run it to the back here. And then this one here is the front one. And I'm going to have to probably take off the gas tank or at least undo the bolts so I can run it underneath, under the wires, kind of with all these other wires that are running here. And then I'm gonna run it back up on the inside of this headlight cover and then eventually drill the hole right there. So what I'll do now is just run the wires to where they're gonna be. I'll probably just sticky mount them to the bike just in the position where I want, so then I can test it out. Maybe I'll take a ride around like that before I go drilling holes into the bike. I'm just gonna take it for a ride around the block. See what kind of... Whoa, that thing is loud when it chimes up.
Start video recording. Yeah. Wi-Fi on.
Wow. Did I do something to the battery? All right. Test has been delayed. When I installed the dash cam yesterday and I went to test it out and start the bike, it wouldn't start. And at first I thought I screwed something up with the installation. I couldn't figure out what it was because it's pretty simple, pretty straightforward. But then I figured out pretty quickly the battery was just dead. So I stuck it on a trickle charger yesterday. It did show the battery was low. It charged it. I came out this morning. It was turning over, but it just wasn't starting. So I'm not sure if that's the battery, but when then I hooked up to a multimeter, it seemed like I was getting enough power, so I'm not sure what the issue is there. I do know these things are known to have issues with the relays, and I still have the original relays in the bike. Now, when I first bought the bike, because I heard so many issues, I did order new relays, the higher quality relays from Hitchcock Motors, and I've had them ever since then, but I've just never changed them. So I'm gonna change the relays, see if that fixes the issue. If not, I think it might be the battery, and I'm just gonna have to buy a new battery. So I did take the relays out. The relays themselves don't look bad. They don't look corroded or anything. I mean, they are kind of gummed up a bunch with all that grease they put on. But as I mentioned, I do have these relays that I bought from Hitchcock Motors. So these are the new ones. So I'll put these in. First, I do have some electrical cleaner, so I'm gonna clean these. And I do have some grease to grease up the new ones. install them and see if that makes a difference. Okay, so I got these connectors pretty clean, and I got the new relays here and just put very light grease on it, keep them from corroding, even though I don't expect it much where I live in this desert climate. Okay, get those back on. And these things have these little slots and tabs there, so they just slide, or should slide, right back into place like that. Nice and easy. So let's try this again.
It started.
Start video recording.
And you can, even over the loudness of my bike, you can hear the camera, the dash cam starting up, the little voice control that tells you that it's on. All right, so the purpose of this test is just to test the placement of the dash cams. I have them fairly close to where I want them, but I want to test them out, see how they look, see how they work. I mean, just taking it around the block should give me enough information to know about the placement. Right now, they're just on there with the sticky tape, which in this heat, I don't really trust. The sun just likes to melt these things right off. So the front camera is 4K. Right now I have it mounted kind of high up on the little windscreen there, the headlight cover. The plan is to mount it actually a little bit down lower. And on the rear, same deal. I have it mounted a little bit higher now than I want it. I'm going to drill a hole and put it just a little bit lower, but that's about the spot where I want it, right in the front, right in the back. No obstructions. I mean, that is one thing is I've noticed some people mount it on their bike, but I've seen some of them mount it like on the side fork where it's being blocked by the other half of the bike, so they're only getting half of the view, which I don't understand. All right, so I think that should be enough information to help me decide how I want to mount these cameras. Okay, as I mentioned, before I go drilling into the metal cowl, I have this cheap plastic one, and I just want to just do a test run on here just to make sure that the way I'm drilling, the angle I'm drilling, that it's going to be able to mount properly, stick out properly, and just make sure I just do it right. I did get this drill bit for drilling into metal, and so I will try it on this. First, I'm just going to drill a little bit of hole to help me line it up, and then give it a try. That's what I want to test first. So I realized this thing is gonna have to be a little bit more secure to hold it in place when I'm doing the metal one, because if it went tearing all over the place with just this plastic one, I'm gonna F it up. All right, so this is onto the real thing, and I have a little bit of leeway up or down, so I don't have to get that exact, but I do want to get exactly in the middle. So put a little X mark there. And same as before, I'm going to start off, drill a little pilot hole, and then we're going to do the deed. Wish me luck. Got a loose chuck here. So, seeing if I can just tighten it. Besides buying a better quality drill, do you know another way to get these things to lock? Pain in the ass. All right, I finally got it to drill through. I got it tightened somehow, but I'm not sure how clean of a cut I got on that as I would like. I mean, I do have
those rubber grommets gonna put in there. So we'll see if it did the job the way I wanted to. Moment of truth, see how this thing looks. I chipped a little bit of paint right there. But once we put the grommet in there, it should hide it, or at least hide most of it. All right. Yeah, pretty much covers the paint up. All right, and I'm gonna have to figure out exactly how to mount it on the inside. It's gonna have to point lower, so I'm thinking something like that, maybe. That's one way of removing it. So, definitely a lot easier. Put the line up. Say it.
Start video recording. Wi-Fi on.
Bike started right up, so I'm guessing it was a dead battery and coincidentally those bad relays. Alright. So I've got the cameras installed right where I want them. They're wedged in there pretty tight, but I don't actually have them locked into place and mounted. They're sort of just wedged into the hole. So I wouldn't trust it for long distances or bumpy roads. They'll probably come out of place. But for right now, I think they're good. And I just want to give them a try just to see where they're pointing. If they're pointing up too high, if I need to level them out a bit. And then once I know that they're in a good spot, I can then create permanent brackets to hold them in place. You can see the front one right there, the front of the bike. And I think they look pretty good where they're at. You know, they kind of blend into the bike. Like I said, I might want to get better grommets, more tapered grommets that I think would fit a little more flush. And then also, if we look at the one on the back, you can see how the back one sits. Again, same thing, get a grommet that maybe will sit a little bit better on the bike. Sit a little more flush, but overall, I like the way they look. We'll just have to see how they actually perform. And then, like I said, make some more permanent brackets for them.